Hey guys and girls, welcome back to the Bitcoin series, where I try to find a way to make a passive income through digital currency mining. My name is Jake Owens, and this is Millionaire Mindset Hub. In this episode, we take a look at why the value of digital currencies rise and fall. Alright, let's get into it. There was a term I used a lot a few episodes ago, which is called, what is a currency exchange and how does it work? If you haven't seen that episode, I recommend you pause this video now, go and watch it, the link is in the description box below, then come back and watch this video. Alright, is everyone back? Great. The term I used a ton in that video was supply and demand, which is the entire reason digital currency prices rise and fall, depending on the supply of the currency and the demand from the market. In this video, I'm going to be using Bitcoin as the example, however these concepts can be applied to any currency, traditional or cryptocurrency. Essentially, at any one time, there is a definitive amount of coins in the marketplace. Therefore, because it's not unlimited, this creates scarcity, because it's not possible for everyone to own as many bitcoins as they want. Due to the scarcity, it creates a competitive marketplace, essentially an auction, where you must outbid everyone else in the marketplace to obtain each bitcoin that you would like to buy. Now, to fully understand this, let's look at this by using simple mathematics. Let's say that there were 100 bitcoins in the marketplace, and on the first day of opening, there were 20 people who wanted to purchase one bitcoin each. Because there was an abundance of coins compared to the demand of people wanting bitcoins on that first day, there was virtually no auction as there were no need to outbid each other to purchase the currency as there were so many, so they all got bitcoins for $1 each. On the second day, there were 80 bitcoins, and again, only 20 people who wanted to buy bitcoin, so they each got one bitcoin for $1 each. The same thing happened on the third, fourth, and fifth day. On the sixth day, one of the people who purchased bitcoin realized that he didn't want it anymore and would rather sell it to purchase something else. So, on the sixth day, he put it onto the market to sell, and on that same day, 20 people happened to be in the market wanting to purchase one bitcoin each. However, unlike the last 100 people, unless 20 are willing to sell their coins, they all can't have a bitcoin on the sixth day, because the last 100 people bought all of the bitcoins in the market. So, they each have two choices, to come back another day when more bitcoins might be available, or outbid the others who want to purchase the one bitcoin on offer in the marketplace. And so, the auction begins. Person 1 bids $1 because he feels like he shouldn't have to pay any more than the other 100 people did who were able to buy bitcoin before him. That person 2 doesn't feel that same way, so he bids $1.20 for the one bitcoin. Person 3 bids $1.40, all the way up to person 15, who by this time 5 people have dropped out of the auction before it even begun, and the price of bitcoin has now reached $3.80, and the person who sold the bitcoin made a $2.80 profit after everyone but one person dropped out of the auction. Then, on the seventh day, the original 19 people who didn't receive bitcoins the previous day and a following 20 people came to the marketplace looking for bitcoin. And it just so happened that someone heard about the profit the last person who sold bitcoin made, so they themselves put their bitcoin on the market. And on that day, they made $7 revenue with a $6 profit, which was $3.20 higher than yesterday's profit, because the demand was higher on the seventh day, consisting of 29 people, but the supply stayed the same at one bitcoin. Now, translate that exact same concept to millions of people around the globe who want to purchase a limited supply of bitcoins. Because there aren't enough bitcoins to go around for everyone who wants one, therefore, as the demand continues to increase and the supply gets smaller and smaller, the price will increase as bitcoin becomes more and more popular, allowing it to reach new heights such as on June 11th, 2017, where it hit $3,000 per bitcoin. This is also applied vice versa, where if the supply is greater than the demand, the price will fall or remain at a lower amount, because everyone will get the amount of bitcoins that they want to buy without needing to bid over anyone else. And that is the essence of supply and demand. When there is supply and little demand, prices are low. And when there is great demand, but little supply, the prices increase. Hey guys and girls, thanks for watching. I really hope you enjoyed this video and it answered all of your questions on why digital currency prices rise and fall. If this video provided you with any value and you feel that way inclined, please feel free to hit that subscribe button and like the video. If you have any questions at all or just want to reach out and say hi, please feel free to do so in the comments section below or just simply PM me. Again, thanks a ton for watching, and I look forward to seeing you in the next episode. Cheers.